Hey, all. Sorry about that. I did not update the title. But we're good to go. We are live. And raring to go. We're gonna start a new game. We'd go. So, welcome to Northgard. Northgard is kind of an interesting game. In it, you're able to play as one of a bunch of different Viking clans, each with their different strengths and weaknesses. And different abilities and stuff like that. Makes them all really, really unique and really interesting. As when you start a new game, you can pick a clan, you can pick a color, difficulty level. I'm just gonna stick with normal map size. I like big maps. It means I can do more before, a game end scenario. So, I'm gonna go with the Clan of the Kraken. Which, they do not travel the sea. They do not travel on the sea. You would think that they would, but they don't. They're not necessarily sea travelers, so what is it? Wielders of Fate, the mighty Norns of Limbakar, master the forces of the weird, and can turn into fierce Valkyries. The clan of the Kraken. Faithful worshippers of the brutal sea thrives on its fish-filled coasts, but knows the dangers too well to sail offshore. So they don't sail, you can't make sailboats and stuff like that. Clan special features: Norns and Valkyries, spectral warriors, fisheries. Things like that. You get some different special abilities. Eda of Vor, you get 1,000 weird. When you build this relic, your Norns also produce fame. Fame bonuses, future sight, and howl of the sea monster. Military units killed in neutral or enemy in a neutral or enemy zone have a chance to become spectral warriors, joining your ranks under your orders. Fishermen produce more move feud. You can't build longship docks. Trade victory is not available to you. Colonization and building costs on non-coastal zones are 50% more expensive. All units' attack power is reduced by 30% in non-coastal zones. Let's say that. So, let's play. Starsman, thank you for the follow. Really appreciate the follow. Thank you for the support. All right. It's been a while. All right. So we got people collecting food first. Food is important. I'm going to take someone. We're going to enter the build menu. I'm going to build a woodcutter's lodge over here. Scout camp built as well. And then we'll also get a fishery. Right, I don't need to necessarily select anybody in particular. Until I need to order them to take up a certain job. Alright, scouts will explore on their own. Alright, let's also get to building this thing. Alright, we've got a new area explored. It is a coastal zone, so we can colonize it. We'll do that here in a second. There's the other way I can make the UI bigger. That's unfortunate. Next villager in a bit. And we need to assign somebody to be a logger to help out with that. I'll just get one. Norn for now. I can have up to two. That's okay. You come over here, get us more food. Yeah, let's colonize this area. Alright. Needs more houses. Oof.
I'm under attack. Alright, looks like we'll need to get a healer's hut. And we should also get a training camp. Oh, I thought it was closer to a coastal zone. I'd have to go down here. Here, yeah, we can colonize that. Training camp. That's why it was more expensive. I've established contact with some giants. I think they're giants. Trade enough food with them and they might join you. Looks like I should set up a marketplace next, I think. Trade post and marketplace. Let me enough wood. Experience. Okay, we've got some work to do. Okay, the healer's doing their job. Okay, that's full. Could make another scout. I don't think I want to do that right this second. Winter's here. All right, let's get that trade post. You have enough lore to acquire new knowledge. Sharp axes. I need to get Endless Tide and Foresight. Next. couple of wolves there. I need a few more soldiers. Now we get 4 wood. So I'm gonna need to get more woodcutters. What's this? Draugr tombs. Draugr will rise from this place until you take control of it. Ah, okay. Clan is starving, you need to produce more food. Yep. Let's take the Valkyrie over here. Okay, we've made it to the new year. You go ahead and... Well, actually... Oh, colonize first. Okay. That's okay. Then I don't need you as a scout. I need you as a merchant. And even then... We need another fishery. Set. I need to produce and store more food. Oh. Okay, we're fine. Let's stay in this area for now. Alright, leadership, guardian, or legions. access to new building watchtower, protects his zone from enemies and oversees adjacent zones, also reduces military experience. Military base, military camps produce 1 military experience, 10 max. Reduce cost of military buildings. While in battleground zone, your zones, your units have 30% attack power and attack speed bonus. Every 6 months, the militias arrive to defend your territory. Militias are defensive units that cannot leave allied territory. You can have a maximum of 4 militias in your territory. You get a free watchtower upgrade each year. Your war chief can place a spike barricade. Okay, we'll do this one. That wasn't what I wanted. Okay, there we go. Why'd she go over there? We get Endless Tide. No, that's not them. That's somebody else. Oh, there they are. I don't have any iron to give right now, so... I could take this area, if I have enough food. Right now, getting more food is the goal. Let's see here. Here, let the fishers do their thing. You come be a merchant.
Hey, Waffle Iron. How's it going? Let's see. I've actually been following this game a bit. How are you finding it? I kind of like it. It's kind of interesting. I mean, it's different than what. It's different than what I would normally expect. From a strategy RTS game, it's more leaned into the city building. Ooh, they got the dragon one. That's a. That's a rough group, military-wise. They've launched an attack. Oh, there he is. No, I lost my Norns. It's definitely interesting because you have to deal with the different changes in the seasons and stuff. And there is a lot of actual city building that city building and planning that you have to work on. Which it does have an effect on things. But I think it's kind of enjoyable. When you get used to it starts doing pretty well. That's kind of right up my alley. Yeah. So yeah, it's kind of its own city builder. It reminds me a little bit of Age of Empires, but they do have certain limitations, like land has certain limitations for structures. But I do like the variety of different clans that they have. They have a bunch of different, they all have their different strengths and weaknesses. Which seems to be a huge help. Oh, they have a scout there. All right. Let's get some foresight. But yeah, so you've got like different types of tech upgrades that you need to work on. You've got special abilities that you can use. The seasons change, the effects of the seasons affect your food and resource generation, things like that. And they also all have their different strengths and weaknesses. Of course, you have to balance things to help things lead to. Yeah, it is. It has its intense moments. Early on, it can be pretty relaxed. need a lore master. Actually, I need a Norn, and then I need a lore master. You get two Norns, that should help with overall happiness. There it goes. What's my population limit? 16? Okay. Establish contact with a new faction. Interesting thing is that they actually have their own campaign as well. It's not just like start a game and then play it. Like what I did that earlier, which is where we got to where we are. But they have a full, seems like they have a full campaign. Where's the attack coming from? Oh, there's the attack. Run away! Now attack. Build a watchtower in this area as well. Oh, so that's how you get a war chief. There's some things about it that's like they don't necessarily, it's not directly intuitive. But it's a work in progress, I guess. Bonfire's construction will begin soon. Watchtower. What was this thing? Oh, it was an axe thrower camp. Okay, good. Let that work on. That's done as well. Oh, we can get another warrior. Okay, I'm gonna grab him and bring him over. Be a warrior, because I need at least a builder in some of these different areas. Alright, bring you over there. You actually be a merchant. Help out with that. Oh, we do need to get more houses built. What are you healing? Oh, you're healing the fisherman. Okay. Yeah, we are running low on food. Oh no! Yeah, we are getting pretty surrounded. We can't build up in this area. We didn't exactly get a good spot to build. We get a hunter's lodge. So
already three buildings in this area. Good thing I already built a watchtower. What are they building? Axe thrower camp? I mean, once they colonize it, I could probably use my Valkyrie's ability. Oh, and I don't have that ability yet. Alright, you get food. We get fur coats. Hey, Astro, this is... Uh-oh. This is a game called Northguard. We can't have more people because we can't build more houses, which it's more difficult to build more houses because we only have a tiny area to work. Them, just some other mercenary. Alright, we are heading into winter, so it's gonna get more difficult. We did lose a warrior. No, we didn't. They lost warriors. Actually, we'll send a warrior to go join and be in the hunting area. That should help cut down costs a bit. But yeah, it's Northguard. It's kind of a RPG. Well, not really an RPG. It's an real-time, it's a RTS game. That's kind of a bit more leaning towards the city builder side of it, but it has some aspects similar to like Age of Empires. Alright, we're losing one food per, but we're okay at the moment. But yeah, right now we're a pretty small nation. Looks like other nations might be bigger than us. Yeah, they got berserkers and stuff. I can't tell what faction they are, but they did loot the ruins. I was having food generation issues early on, and I'm still kind of having those issues. We got mining efficiencies so that we can get near the sea spirit and knowledge from beyond. Alright, I need ore. Axe throwers. Oh, they're building up something. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna let that build up. But yeah, that's the game we're playing right now. As long as I'm able to keep trading food with them, things should be all right. You're under attack. Where am I under attack? That's where I'm under attack. This is only one place for me to expand to, and I need to get enough. I need to break into that area and colonize it. Call to arms. Nice. Okay.
Not far.
Reinforcements have arrived. We have militia units now. Should help quite a bit. Put the mine here. That should give us materials, and we'll put a house here. And we just need all right, I have to go here. And then have them. Thank you. No, we're tied with somebody. Guess it is considered a coastal zone. Okay. That's good to know. Now I can cast Ancient Spirits. An ominous shade prowls under the sea. The Kraken strike. Oh no! Building's full, okay. Alright, well, in that case, first, we're gonna build a watchtower. Come on. Watchtowers are free, they don't cost any extra building space. Near the sea. All right, let's get Freya's blessing first. At least a hunter's lodge would be pretty temporary. Nice. Okay, now we've got enough food. Mm, yeah. Another warrior. Clan can't grow because they are unhappy. I think we might actually take this area. Is this from the first time you're playing the game? Yeah, this is the first time I'm playing the game. I did notice that it is kind of lagging a little bit. Hey, that made people happy. And we'll be capturing this area here in a second. Oh no. You gotta retreat and heal up, I guess. Now these guys can't move into... Alright, you know what? You come over here, become a warrior. Wasn't sure what the weight of expansion looked like. It seems like it escalates at a reasonable rate. Wasn't sure what the rate of expansion looks like. They seem to release a lot of, well, the rate of expansion kind of varies depending on the clan that you pick and where you end up being located. I ended up being located not really that close to...
I ended up being located not that close to any friendly areas. Or at least not a lot of coastal areas. So it kind of limits, it kind of limited what I could, what I can do and how much I could expand compared to how many others could, how much other factions could expand. Although our map might not be that big right now. Let's see, they've got a warrior, axe thrower, warrior, and the people in there. Okay. Get an axe thrower. Actually, we can probably get... Once that's done, I'll turn that into an axe thrower. Warrior. Warrior. Oh, they had to pull back for something. Yeah, it also depends on like how many people you can make, you can train, and things like that. So mines are the most temporary ones you can. Oh, we're coming in here now. I've got to target this guy. Take him out first. New title. Okay, I reached the Thane title, and that was way out. Got more glory from that. We've got an okay group still, so that's okay. Oh, okay. But yeah, a lot of people are reaching Jarl status and stuff like that. An ability unlocked, suppressing fire. Oh, we lost a lot of troops on that one. At least I forced it into neutrality, so. Alright, we'll colonize this area. We'll let this one be destroyed. Take out this one. But now...
Oh, okay. Well, I own the relic, so... They can't start summoning wolves. But now we can build a forge. Or we can forge a forge. I mean, I could have built one there too, but... Alright, let's get another warrior and another axe thrower. Because we lost pretty much everyone. Right, I need. Oh, hey! Perfect. Uh-oh. Okay. No, never mind that. You come over here and build that then. A lot of it also includes personnel management. Oh, that's what I need to set up first. I need to get iron, and then I can start build. And then I can build relics. Let's also upgrade. Get these upgrades done. With these upgrades, I can should be able to do more. Oh no. I had no idea about that one. Oh wait, never mind. You. Hey, come over here and build that. Repair that. And then when he's done with that, we'll put him to work at the forge. Defensive strategy sounds good to me. Okay, you going over here and help. Hunter. Go. under attack. Ah, they ran away. Bullying him. I've been typically leaving him alone. Oh, fallen sailors are coming in. One thing I like about the Kraken is that you get a very early warning about what's about special events and stuff. Get a watchtower. To be able to build a house here. I need iron. I don't have any iron right now. But that's one of the reasons why I'm building this marketplace here. It might take some time for some of that stuff to show up. What is he built in this area? Thank you.
I could push in to these guys' territory again. But I don't really feel like doing that. Oh wait, repair that first. There we go. Under attack. Where are we under attack from? Oh, down there. Yeah, we're gonna lose a fisherman. Oh, never mind. Not bad. Okay. Move everybody up over here. When you do feasts, it generally increases productivity. Almost made complete friends with... with these guys. They have an offering well. I don't think I have enough of a force to take on a watchtower and whatever else if they move units into this area. Summons a draconic Jotun. Okay, that's one of these giants. Let's go Yord's Blessing. Then we should be able to forge a relic. Let's go the Mjolnir route. Let's upgrade the town hall. Upgrade this house. And can't upgrade that house right now. There it goes. Now we're getting into upgrades. Oh, right, I get free watchtower upgrades every month. I think it's every month. It's either every month or every year.
Okay. What was it? Every year you get a free watchtower upgrade. Okay, cool. Alright, as soon as I can get enough, what is that, stone, I should be able to upgrade this marketplace and get more crowns. Looks like they've been in a fight with somebody. Their trade post. Some iron there that they haven't even used yet. I need 6 more. I should make another marketplace for trading post. I should put it right here. Just need a villager to build it. And man it. No, they killed them. No, they didn't join my. I couldn't. It's destroyed, yep. Valhalla's reinforcements, that'll be nice. Monster Slayer, that'll be useful. Looks like I need to. Thank you. Starting to get into the negatives. Got a bit of a band there. But no watchtower, so the best chance would be to head over here and push these guys. Oh, they have one watchtower. Wow, I lost those troops real fast. Alright, increased happiness though. Oh, wait a minute. Don't I have a relic to place or something? I do. Got no place to build this said relic. Now I can place it. Oh, there's already another relic in this area. Hold the line. Warchief can place a spike barricade to hurt enemies entering the zone. Oh, nice. Oh, they do have an upgraded tower. Just didn't see it. Right, not enough coin to do that. Oh, they are the wolf clan. Dragon, goat, stag, boar, bear. All right, let's... I just need two of those, and then I can upgrade this. Let's get another merchant. And send a warrior, send the warrior over here. I forgot I took one out of off of that list in that group. There's not a whole lot I can do about that right now. Well, guys, I think I'm going to call it here. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this short little stream here. Sorry, I would have done a little bit earlier. Would have done a bit longer, but kind of got started late anyway. My Valkyrie go? Oh, she's right there. Thank you guys so much. I will see you guys next time. Oh, quick announcement. I have a Discord server up and running, so you guys can join the Discord server, socialize with me, other gamers like us, and of course get notifications on when I am, and get live notifications for when I am live. Thank you guys, and I will see you guys next time.